fuck is this music? I clearly like it. I seem to be finding the worst music in the world tonight. Where's my chat? Where's my chat? We've got announcements. Hello, everybody. How's it going? Hello. Hello, Wing. Hello, Braden, Farrell, Coconut, Speedy, Ramen Boy, Drax. Yeah, final stream. I got a lot to announce. I'm just going to wait for like a couple more people to arrive. Have I seen Chappie? Sarah Sen? I have seen Chappie. I love Chappie. Chappie's the shit, bro. So a couple of announcements we're going to make tonight. One of them is I'm going to be like splitting my channel down the middle. Hello, Borkorm. Hello, Nick. Hello, Rab. Ramen Boy, Paradox, Phantom, JD. Jesus, there's a lot of you guys. How's everybody doing? Hello from England. Hello. We've got English, South Africans, Americans. There's a bunch of you. Good Lord. Is my stream smooth? Am I looking good? Is it like, can I sound nice? Big gay. Oh, fantastic. Thank God. Whew. So yes, I'm moving to Chatterbait. Finally, I'm just going to, you know, crank that. Okay, so what I've done is I have disabled spamming of chat, so you guys can't spam. It's very smooth in the UK. Fuck yes! Loving it. Thank you, Vitamin D. We love you too. Everything looks great. Okay, so we've got a couple of announcements to make. The final stream on my YouTube channel. So at the moment, I just had Mr. Flack. Let me actually show you guys. So in the description of the stream, looking good, bro. Fucking rocking on, bro. So in my previous video, I announced that I'm making a new channel because I do a lot of things other than gaming. Gaming is like my passion somewhat. I like exploring. Hello, Slithian. How's it going? YouTube is like a passion of mine in terms of gaming. I do love gaming. Away, Charlie. Wat pomp. Dear husband, congrats on 10,000. 10,000? Okay, whatever. So, I do a lot of things in life other than gaming. Sometimes I do gaming. Yes, I love gaming, but I also like other things. I do a lot of like carpentry and, you know, woodwork and making of things. And I do a bunch of shit, right? And I don't want to...
Ready to die for Mr. Black Soldier?
Thank you for that. Twitch follow, you fucking legend. So what I do is a bunch of things. Gaming occupies maybe 20% of my day. So I want to split my channel into gaming and me, because I've got a lot of bros. I mean, if you guys are part of my Discord, you'll know that I'm very active in my community. I love hanging out with the bros. So yeah, the new channel, the Extra Flack channel, is going to be like a vlog, DIY, like a sort of variety channel. And then my Mr. Flack channel will be dedicated gaming. So that was the announcement of the new channel. If you guys do want to see the new channel, I can actually post the link if you want to see. I'm so not used to YouTube. I usually stream on Twitch, so everything seems a little bit strange, but let me try and find, yeah, but here's the channel. Yeah, I'm actually going to post it for you guys. Copy, and I'm going to paste it right over Control V. There we go. That's the new channel. You guys can follow it if you want to, because a lot of people just want to see my Rust videos. They have no desire to see like my, oh, it's in the description. Duh. They just want to see my Rust stuff. They don't give a fuck about Mr. Flack as a person, but a lot of my bros in my Discord, a lot of my community enjoy me as a person, you know, as a father, as a husband, as a sort of person in the career. So the new channel is going to be great. I'm going to upload my random shit to there. I subbed. What a fucking legend. Thank you so much, bro. Now, the codes. I can see everyone's very excited about this competition. I actually didn't expect to get this much interest. I noticed a lot of people are freaking out looking for this code. I love you, Flack, as a person. I love you, JD, as a fucking faceless avatar. Love you. 100th sub. Congratulations, Phantom. Own that shit. Okay, so the code. In my video, I paused it on this moment so you guys can see. The next 5 videos starting in this video. So the first code was in this video, in the new favorite hidden base video, okay? It's a 4-digit secret code hiding in a frame. It's occupying 3 to 5 frames. It's actually occupying 7 frames. So a small bit of movement will contain the code, okay? But as a show of good faith, I wanted to give you guys some tip. I was Flack's first sub. Yes, you were. or I'll keep an eye out for your uploads on the new channel. Thank you, I appreciate that. So the code, the first code is in this video. It's going to be a 4-digit code, okay? The next video is going to have a 4-digit code. The next video is going to have a 4-digit code. The next video is going to have a 4-digit code. Next video is going to have four. It's going to be 20 digits in total. And then once I release that fifth and final video, I'm going to tell everybody, okay, there is going to be like a an email address. So you have to email that 20-digit number at something.com. And you send a message to that custom email address. I win. And the first person to mail me wins it. Now, as a show of good faith, I want to give you guys a tip. So the first code is between 1 minute and between 2 minutes. Okay, between 1 minute and between 2 minutes of my whole 10-minute video, it's somewhere there. And it occupies, you see where my face is? It occupies the lower left-hand side of the screen. So that's the first clue. What would the person win? $500 PayPal. Quite a chunk. I mean, it's not the most money in the world, but it's not exactly a tiny amount either. So that is regarding the competition. Then I had a lot of people also asking me, let me catch up on the chat. 13th sub. Can't be the 13th sub. There's already 100. Well, email bounced when I emailed it. Can I check your... Nobody knows what the email address is yet. So the 4-digit code, 4444, it'll be a 20-digit number at, for example, gmail.com. And then you will say, I went to that. So a lot of people didn't really understand. That's why I actually wanted to do a live stream to like describe to you guys what exactly happens. Blaze. Hello, Flack. Hello, Blaze. How are you? I wanted to give you guys a clue between 1 minute and between 2 minutes. And it's hiding in 7 frames worth of footage. It's a 4-digit code. Once you get, I know, all these strangers. Hello, Xander. Are you all? That's my moderator's brother. So what we'll do is we'll get that code. We will, you'll hang on to it. The next video will also have another code and again, times 5. Once you get that, you send it. When it gets to the last 4 digits, can I just guess the last 4? You know, if you'd like to, but with 4 digits, guessing it would be 99,999 possibilities. So you make the best basis. I built one and it lasted all wipe. Thank you. I appreciate that so much. Also, a lot of people wanted to know about my new setup. And as I'm sitting here now, I'm looking at my new setup and it's actually a joke. Yemenite Jew. Good Lord, that name. I'm from South Africa.
You ready to die for Mr. Black Soldier?
Thank you for the Twitch follow, you fucking sexy man. Monty, hello. How are you, Monty? It's not too bad. $500 is a lot of fucking cheddar, boys. So, about my setup, right? I've got this new partner on board. You guys know Predator, Acer Predator. They sent me... I actually wanted to show you guys my setup because it's actually comical. What up, Flack? Hello, Ricardo. Wow, it's been a while. Haven't seen you in ages. How's it going, my friend? So, this is going to be a bit of a stuff up. So let me show you my setup, and let me show you some really fucking cool. What country in South Africa? South Africa is a country, friend. Africa is a continent. I'm going to show you guys. No poor language in the stream, my friend. So I wanted to show you guys my setup because it's actually a joke now. Are you guys ready? Watch here. This is my new setup. I'm not even joking. I wish I was joking. But that's it. I have a laptop.
You ready to die for Mr. Black Soldier?
Not Bloods has followed on Twitch. Thank you for the Twitch follow. I've got a screen behind here, but that's my old screen. It's mounted to the wall, and I kind of don't want to take it off. I've got one screen to the left. I've got my microphone over here, and I've got my keyboard. And this is my entire setup. So now this is, you know, my gaming computer, my streaming computer, my everything. So let me give you guys a quick rundown of the coolest thing. So over here, it's got two really cool features. It's got a turbo button over here, and it's also got a Predator button. When I push the Predator button, I get this this sort of Predator monitoring screen. You see the screen over here?
Are you ready to die for Mr. Black Soldier?
Oh, all these Twitch follows. Thank you, guys. Welcome to the family. Read the last. Let's have a look. Benny, codes are in the vid posted on this channel, though, yeah? Yes. I'm not going to be posting it on the other one. This competition is reserved to Mr. Flack. So let's have a look at this great device, okay? So you've got your Predator Sense, and Predator Sense is like this all-encompassing program that runs your entire sensor. If you guys can see here, it's currently running on 62% CPU. GPU is at 62 degrees. 50 degrees and 53 degrees for the system. Now, this system, this tiny little system, now, it's very difficult to describe because I'm completely plugged in at the moment. I can't pick it up and show you guys the device. But if I show you how thin the screen is, you guys can get an idea of just how thin this device is. In fact, if you guys are not from America and the land where they measure things with fucking eagle toes and, you know, yardsticks and shit. So much follows. Blaze, thank you for the follow. Chupapa, thank you for the follow. All my live streaming, guys, will be happening on Twitch. So if you guys do want to see some more live shit, is it the one with two fans? No, this has got three fans. Let's have a look at the fan control. I've got a CPU fan and I've got two GPU fans. Why do I have two GPU fans on a laptop that is skinnier than my X? Well, I can tell you. What you have to notice is that this has got a RTX 2080 graphics card in it. In 18 millimeters. In 18 millimeters, it's got an RTX 2018. I mean, that's staggering. It's got, obviously, the 2080. Yeah, it's got an 8th generation i7. And it is an absolute fucking beast. It's so OP. And the nice thing is that this laptop was designed with energy efficiency in mind. So let's just go over a couple of the features. For example, you get the turbo button. Once you see it's normal, fast, and extreme. Once I put on the turbo button, you'll hear it goes very loud. I'm going to move the mic quick, guys. It's actually, Drax, it's actually 55,000 Rand. The 35,000 Rand one is the i5 with the 2060. This is a top range machine, and it runs, it's got a little turbo button. So when you push the turbo button, it overclocks everything. It overclocks your CPU to 4.4 gigahertz. It overclocks your graphics card to 1,800 megahertz over here, but only once you play. And it just rocks the system out. I mean, I'm going to open up a game here, for example, right? Now, bearing in mind that I've got my actual OBS running on my second screen, so that's a program that is very... Oh my god, there's so many followers, I love you guys. So, bearing in mind that I am running my OBS, and the OBS is actually rendering this whole thing, okay? So, keep that in mind, because that does take a lot of CPU power. If I open up my Control-Shift-Escape screen, you will see my 12 CPUs. Fucking 12 CPUs, boys. It's disgusting. Are you getting lag? Is anyone else lagging? I see Monty's getting some lag, or are you guys still good? Does Monty need a new internet connection, or does Flack need one? So, 12 CPUs, it's got an RTX 2080 graphics card, and the reason why my setup, as you guys saw earlier, my entire setup looks like I'm a student on a little desk. I've gotten rid of my entire PC case, all my screens, nothing. I don't need it anymore. Like, I don't need it. I've got this laptop, and it is an absolute beast. It's like five times stronger, dudes, than my old gaming machine. It's five times stronger. The entire thing is made out of metal, and it is like the sexiest shit you can imagine. In fact, it's so sexy. Let me show you how it looks. I can't obviously unplug everything because of my multiple screens, but let me show you something. I love you, Phantom Zone. I love you like a son, motherfucker. Okay, so let's have a look quickly. I want to show you guys something cool. Not the Rust video. Nope, none of that. So give me a second, lads. Oh, wait, you know, before I show you, let me show you the casing. I'm getting a bit confused. Let me show you the fucking casing. This is its launch video, and it's like the coolest shit I've ever seen. Now, you can at least get a picture of how thin it is. I do. If that didn't give you goosebumps, then you obviously like Apple Mac. Yes, I live in South Africa. Oh, I live in Cape Town. I do. So yes, it's also got RGB. That is a slight letdown. I'm not gonna lie. So let's have a look at the lighting. It's a little bit of a problem. At the moment, I've got like this little glow. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's got like a wave, because I've picked a cold wave, so it's got dark blue, light blue, dark blue, light blue. You came a little. Good. God, Becca. So you get your static, which is this, but it's a three zone. What it means by three zone is that it actually has like lighting only in three sectors, unfortunately. It doesn't have the full RGB, as you can see here. I've put off certain zones. It's got three zone, and the reason why it only has three zones, guys, is because it is such a thin laptop that they couldn't actually fit a proper RGB controller into it. So they had to just make a normal three zone one, which is not bad, because I mean, you still get your dynamic, you get your make the camera bigger again, you get your normal wave. You can choose all, 28 billion fucking lights. It's your choice. You can do, the waves. I like the cold wave, but you get, ugly, weird things like this, for example, which is, mental. You get your media waves, you get your breathing. Now, the really cool thing about this, I'm gonna leave it on cold wave. The really cool thing I like about this whole thing is it's got so much like use. Like if I'm mid game, right? So say I close it, okay, and I'm mid game and I push my Predator button, my monitor program comes up and then it allows me to work on my things. I think I minimized it now. No, I didn't. Can it run Crysis? I don't think anything can run Crysis. Or do you use a mouse? I use a mouse. I use this keyboard because it feels so good. It's got like a little mechanical mini keyboard. It's, have a listen. It's got such a nice little click to it. It feels amazing. Your FLAC, Phantom, and I are OGs. We subbed at 300 and 320. Fuck yes. Thank you, SHA24. Oh, you found the code! Nice, Kevin. GG. Kevin used the tip that I gave earlier. If anybody wants the tip to be re-announced, let me know. I do use a mouse. It's not an Acer mouse, but I plan on getting. The thing is, I've now seen Predator's build quality. This whole thing, okay, is metal. It's not plastic. The entire thing is metal. Everything is extremely high quality. And yes, the price tag is it's rough, but now. Yeah, Galaxy, I gave everybody a final tip on where the first code is. I'll give it to you back in a second, but I just want to carry on with my little expose. So I've shown you guys. Wait, let me get the camera back on me. Sorry, this camera is a bit like awkward. Is that fine? You guys see me? Do I look sexy? Do I look amazing? Oh, there we go. Wait, a little bit more there. Is that good? A little bit up. Sorry, I'm not a live streamer, so it feels a bit strange. So. The nice thing I like about this, right? So you've got your custom fan controls, you've got your overclocking controls, you've got it's an Epic Gamer laptop, boy. It really is. I love this device, and that's why I got rid of my gaming PC, because I no longer have a need for it. I've got my little laptop, my second screen, my mouse, and my mic, and everything is it's enough. I'm tired of having this enormous monitor and 500 screens and a mouse pad that is 18 miles long. I'm so over it. I'm so over it. So I decided, simplify, get this laptop. And the nice thing is, say for example, I'm here, okay? Now that I'm a YouTuber, I'm doing a lot of traveling. Oh yeah, you guys like that flat boy, don't you? That thick boy. Now that I travel, now I'm a YouTuber, I go to events, I travel, I go to Johannesburg, the other side of the country, quite often. And when I go, I always have to try and calculate if I'm not making YouTube videos and I'm going to Joburg, I'm losing money. Because while I'm sitting here, this is how I make my money. So now I've got this laptop and it's so light. It's like 2 kilograms heavy, or 4 pounds if you come from the land of the free. And it's ridiculous. This is my gaming machine. It's this thick. I unplug the cables and then I've got a gaming machine with me at all times. Any bad sides about the laptop? There is. There absolutely is. Please, I don't want people to think that I'm a corporate sellout that that just talks good about products. It's not bad. I don't like the RGB keyboard in terms of its three zone lighting. I wish it had full lighting. However, in the same breath, I don't use multiple patterns, so it doesn't really bother me. But I would have liked the option to, customize particular keys in particular colors. And that's the thing. It's short. I've always wanted a gaming laptop, but I'm not okay with a laptop being this thick because that's not a laptop. Should get the throat loss. Oh God, can you imagine? I live in Amanus. Oh, lovely. I love Amanus. Varnoozy, I love your videos. I love your name, Varnoozy. Thank you so much. So the bad sides would be the fact that I can't customize individual keys, because I was one of those people that like to like customize my WASD key. Like I'm weird like that. Another negative side is that people seem to think that this laptop is... EMP19, I'll explain to you in a second, buddy. Just hang by. A lot of people seem to think that a gaming laptop is a device that... that basically is at full gaming spec at all times. So you unplug the power cable, and when you're on the bus, you can, you know, crank out Skyrim at like 800 frames per second. It's not like that. A gaming laptop needs to be plugged in. And I've learned that recently. All gaming laptops need to be plugged in. You can't be at full power because these things are like hybrids, okay? They, even at overclocking, I'm currently in extreme. Let me just turn off my extreme. It runs as fast as it needs to. But when it's not on AC power, when it's not on an actual like cord power, if it's on battery, it runs at a minimal state. So when I unplug it and I try and game, it gives me graphics from 2012. And I've recently learned that it's not like Predator that does it. It's all gaming laptops. I didn't realize how much power gaming laptops use. However, if I do travel, I've got my laptop with me, and I can tell you one thing, guys. You know what's nice about this thing? It's sleek, and it's, you know, I mean, you guys saw, it's beautiful, right? The thing I like about it is that it becomes a normal laptop when you unplug the power cable. It goes dead silent. Thank you, Cat Herder, for the Twitch follow. Sexy motherfucker. So the nice thing I like about this thing is that it's smart. So currently, my GPU has got a load on it. Okay? Now, say, for example, I was to stop my Streamlabs. Streamlabs is currently rendering visuals. What it actually does, if you sit here and you don't do any gaming, it actually switches the graphics card physically off. It physically switches off the graphics card. It goes to zero. The temperature goes to zero. The monitoring on the GPU goes to nothing. It's the weirdest thing. Like, it only uses the graphics card when needed. And I know with my gaming PC, it makes the graphics card do 100% all the time. You know what I mean? So, yeah, I see a lot of people asking. They probably joined a bit late. So, for the guys that did join earlier, I do apologize. I'm just going to repeat myself. I've got a gaming channel named Mr. Flack. You guys are currently watching it. I'm splitting that channel up. It's in the description of this video, or of the stream, if you look at the bottom. So I'm splitting my gaming and my lifestyle videos like separate, because I noticed I released like a Rust video and everyone's like, oh my god, such a good video, and then I released like a personal thing and they're like, what the fuck, what is this shit, and then my views like plummet to the ground. So that is unfortunate. And you know what the funny thing is, guys, about the screen, right, about this laptop as well, another thing that really,
you ready to die for Mr. Flack, soldier?
Ambient Car 2 and Kremlin, hello guys, thank you for the Twitch followers, I do appreciate it. Open the folder trash. Should I open the folder trash? I don't know. No, I'm not gonna open that.
You ready to die for Mr. Flack, soldier?
I don't trust myself, quite frankly. Can you play PUBG in external monitor and get an external keyboard? Exactly. You actually can. You can do that. You can, like, at the moment, I've got a secondary screen plugged in, and even with the second screen plugged in, the GPU rocks. I mean, let me just open up a game, for example, like Rocket League. I mean, Rocket League isn't a very intensive game, but it's got the 144Hz screen. It's got G-Sync. It is absolutely insane. Okay, let me open up trash. I don't trust myself, but okay, just some notes. It's fine. Whew, dodged the bullet. You know which folder you guys missed it, right? Can I buy you a laptop? Unfortunately, Toy Thorpe, I can't. But somebody mentioned, why don't I give my old gaming PC away? Like, maybe you should do that. Maybe I should just give away my old PC. My old PC is a monster, don't get me wrong. It's like, it's huge. But now, okay, I've left my frames on over here. And I'm going to put my, it's currently on 230 frames. Let me go into like a training mode quickly. I like that music. I'm old, so I like that. So I've got, can you guys see on the top right? It's a little bit small. It's on 222 frames a second. I'm going to turn on turbo, obviously, because overclock. It's going to get it up to, let's see. Is it getting better? Okay, it's going to be difficult for you guys to see its graphical potential. Everything's on highest, obviously. But obviously, you guys are looking at 30 frames per second, and I'm looking at 200, well, about 144 frames per second. But it's running the stream, it's running the game, and it's actually not even blinking. Let's have a look here. Okay, it's running at 1,860 megahertz, which is just fucking staggering. We look at the temperatures, it's like, it's not even struggling. It's the weirdest thing. Please don't mention the code in the chat if you guys do find it. I would appreciate it if you didn't. But it's looking good as shit, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, it really is the fastest machine I've ever used. And it upsets me because I spent a lot of money. I spent like 20 grand on my gaming PC. And now I'm struggling to like render videos. And then I start rendering videos on this machine. And then it's just like, out of nowhere, this thing renders 3 times as fast. It plays games literally 10 times as fast as my old PC. So I'm thinking, why don't I just give my old PC away? Or maybe I should sell my PC. I think I'll sell my PC and then I can buy a nice big secondary screen. Because at the moment I've got these old shitty screens. And I was thinking maybe if I can get like a 144Hz screen. The code is 0800001066. So yes, as I announced before, this would be the last YouTube stream. So my Mr. Flack channel now is going to be dedicated Laptop Master Race. Dude, I'm fucking on board, eh? I'm so over the whole box vibe. When you're using the new channel. The new channel, it's going to be in use immediately. When I upload anything non-gaming, it's going to Extra Flack channel. When I upload normal gaming videos, it's going to Mr. Flack. And then when I do like lifestyle videos, Extra Flack. And then when I do streaming, it's going to be... It's going to be primarily on Twitch. What's the tip for the code? Ah, Galaxy. The tip for the code is... Let's see if I have that video open. Give me 1 second, Galaxy. So, you guys cannot probably see this because it's on the wrong fucking screen. There we go. Okay, so the tip is it's before 2 minutes and after 1 minute. So between 1 minute and 2 minutes is the location of the code, and it's on the, let's see if you can see this, it's on the lower left-hand side of the screen over here. So somewhere between 1 minute and 2 minutes on the lower left-hand side of the screen. You take that code, you add up those codes to the next 4 videos. You have a 20-digit code in total, and then I'll give you an email extension at fucking hotmail.com. And then you send that long email address, which is 20 numbers at hotmail.com. I win, and then once you do that, success. In fact, the next few videos that I'm going to release, I'm thinking about doing like a type of... I'm not going to give more hints, but I'm going to give like musical cues. There's going to be a strange sound in the next video, you know what I mean? Like a strange type of sound. What's the code for? It's a $500 giveaway. If you're from South Africa, that's about 7,000 rand giveaway for the first person. Watch my latest video. At the very end of the video, it gives you a little bit of a description on what it could be like. In fact, I'll just play it through right over here and you guys can have a listen for yourself. You're awesome. Also, another thing I would like to mention is that I'm going to be holding a $500 PayPal giveaway. But before you get excited and get your panties in a bunch, please note that this is going to be a very complicated and rather lengthy competition. See, what I plan on doing is hiding a secret code in every video from this video. The first person that emails me the message I win will win a $500 PayPal prize. Obviously, first come, first serve. The secret code will be hidden within the video in a very inconspicuous area. Only the sharpest eyes will find it. So for the next 5 videos, starting with this video, there's going to be small secret codes hiding somewhere in the frames. It'll occupy about 3 frames. Put those codes together in order. It will form an email address. And once you have that email address, the first person that emails me, I win, will win $500 PayPal. A special shout out goes out to my beautiful Patreon. I just hope my fucking Patreons are going to pay for the competition prize money. JK. 4.2 gigabyte updates. Are you kidding me? Oh, Jesus.
Die for Mr. Flack,
soldier. Cool 25 save. Thank you so much for the Twitch follow. So yeah, this is going to be my last live stream. It feels a bit sad because I started up my channel doing live streams. It kind of makes me feel a little bit sad. But yes, this will be my official last one. Anyone agree with the Morse code? Oh, you want to do it in Morse code? I could probably do that. Fun part of me. What's up, Flack? Hello, buddy. How's it going? Welcome. Where's everybody from in the chat? I don't even know where people are from at this stage. I'm just, you know, feel so strange having this much space in front of me. It's like, what? I'm so used to being like cramped up with all these screens and this big box, and now it's like a laptop. Oh, we got Germany. Good lord. I know we got South Africa. Reinhard van Dijk, South African Reinhard RVD. How's it going, buddy? The guy who I love, but I hate his clan. I hate his clan so fucking much. Mitchell's plain old puck. May bless my brother. There's Zas. Norway, Namibia. Belgium, Norway again. Fuck me, bros. Why is it my last stream? I did explain a few seconds ago. I should probably put up like a notification. I'm moving all my live to Twitch. I'm moving all my gaming to Mr. Flack. And then I'm moving all my non-gaming videos to Flack Extra. The link to that channel is in the video description below. USA, Louisiana, Belgium. How's it? Kisses from Brazil, US, Kentucky, Cape Town. Fuck, dude. I love you guys. Let me show you the laptop quickly. I'll actually show you the specs, because somebody asked me how strong is the laptop. Let me show you quick the actual specs of the one that I have. One second, I'm busy loading on another screen. I'm worried that porn's gonna pop up. My luck. Get my channel banned for no reason. One sec, guys. Dudes, this laptop is just, it's jokes. It's actually jokes. Like, they actually contact me. They're like, oh, can we send you this laptop? And then I looked at the specs. I'm like, okay, like, who do I have to, like, you know, basically pleasure in order to earn this? You share it quick. Here we are. So this is the laptop. And it's so fucking pretty. It really upsets me, dudes. It's got the 2080 Ti, but it doesn't have the 9900. It's got the 87 something. It's, oh my god, it's so thin. It's so thin. Good lord. It's very pretty. All metal. That's why I love it. But here's the specs list for you nerds that want to see more. Show more. 15.6 LCD. It's got USB 3. It's got three USB 3 ports. HDMI. It's got mic. Blah, 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 blah. Thunderbolt 3 port and a USB Type-C port. It's got a... I've got the 16 gig version. So it's got 16 gigs of RAM. Jay Sling, what's up, buddy? How's it going? The DDR4, it's upgradable to 32 gigs though. It also has, oh god, yeah, let me tell you some more of the fucking features, bros. It's insane. So it's got so many features. Do you guys know who knows what RAID 0 is? Wait, let me show you the price. RBD, don't judge me, eh? Here's the price over here. If you're not from South Africa, if you're from like Belgium or Brazil or whatever, just convert 54,585 South African rand to, and then my currency, like, let me show you, for example, copy, to US dollar. No, that's rupees. There we go. $3,600. That's like the it's not a cheap machine, but if you buy it from America, you'll pay a lot less. It'll be like $2,500 from like overseas, from America. How hot does it get playing Rust? Weirdly, it only gets to 90 degrees. When you play Rust, it doesn't go further. It doesn't ever have heat soak. No, that's not the code, Blizz. It's a great machine, but what I like... Do you guys know what RAID 0 is? Does anybody know what RAID 0 is? I actually found out a lot about it. That's like half my flat deposit. Good lord. So RAID 0 is pretty cool because it's got two hard drives in it, right? Oh, you do know, 4K? Okay, that's good. But for the people that don't know, it's got two hard drives... that share the information. So like, let's say you've got a 1 gig file that needs to get processed. It doesn't process a 1 gig file. It takes the file, it splits it in half, and it sends half of it to one hard drive, half of it to another hard drive. So it literally cuts the loading time in half. So when I load Rust, it's like, boom, done. So, well, I mean, when I'm off stream, it loads quick. When I'm on stream, unfortunately, it's doing other things as well. But essentially, yes, it takes any data that needs to be processed, splits it in half, and shares it amongst two hard drives. And this thing's got a terabyte of M.2 SSD space. It's pretty sharp. I also want to show you this. This is pretty cool, I must admit. So it's got this Max Audio, which is, it's pretty cool and all. I don't, you know, really care much about audio. It's got a face tracker. Now, the face tracker doesn't work while I've got a secondary camera on, unfortunately. But you guys see this little head here. When I put on face tracking, you'll see on the top left here, the camera clicks on. Now, while I've got a second camera on, it doesn't work so well. But what it does is it actually tracks your head. It's a little bit buggy when I've got two cameras running, but what it does is it tracks your head, right? So, you know, when you're busy playing and then you look around the corner, it'll actually recognize that your head is now in a different position relative to the speakers, and it actually changes the way the games come. So if I'm busy driving forward in a game, okay, and I've got a car sound in front of me and I turn my head like this, it will only play the audio towards my left ear because my right ear will be facing, according to this diagram, away from it. It's actually a smart audio system that curves to where your head's facing. And dude, it's so insane, Becca. I was playing PUBG the other night and I realized the difference, because while I was playing, I didn't have a camera on, and when I was, you know, you lean. Bliss, I have the code. Well done, my friend. It's pretty cool because like I was leaning around a corner, and I know it's not going to help if you lean around a corner, but I did anyway. And then I could hear the sound of the footprints were changing because my head moved away from the camera. Okay, looks like Bliss has officially been removed from the competition. Thank you, Bliss. That's quite annoying. Okay, so Bliss has been officially disqualified from the competition. Well done for that. So this is the actual the audio tech, and the audio tech is very smart because when I turn the audio tech off, wait, let me see if I can give you guys an example. I'm put my Spotify on a bit louder. It will render, so you guys will be actually catch what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna put my music up. Standard audio. Could hear the fullness, and actually it generates so much more warmth from the normal one. Let me get a different song, something that's not fucking AIDS. Oh jeez. Okay, sorry, this is a bad song, but example, without audio, know what I mean? A difference is just staggering. It adds. I must admit, I'm very impressed with this Max Audio. That is one thing that I was absolutely blown away with, just how good the quality of the audio is. It's just like, what? Oh, I'm sorry, I should have probably said, like, spoiler. You're Thanos Synaptobliss. Yes, I'm Thanos. I'm gonna, what competition? Watch my latest video, Lage X. Watch my latest video, and we'll give you a description of exactly what is going down with the competition. $500 PayPal giveaway, bro. Five, significant difference. It's massive. What now is a 4.6... Does anybody know why the Rust update is so big? It seems a little bit too much. Your chat is way behind. Sorry about that, Borkum. I think there might be some kind of delay. Is the stream still smooth, guys? Is everything okay? You guys are... Yeah, in the last video, I announced the competition, $500 PayPal giveaway with a lengthy method on how to approach it. But yeah, it's just great. I wanted to show you guys so much more what this laptop can do, but unfortunately... The main thing that I wanted to get from it, yes, it's smooth. That's a good thing. The reason why, this is so, the reason why I can't unplug the laptop and show you guys is because I actually wanted to run this entire stream from the laptop itself. I mean, if you guys can have a look, it's working, but it's working hard. I'm streaming, I'm playing music, I'm rendering, obviously, my stream itself. I'm playing games, and this thing's not even choking. It is... I hate how powerful it is. It's upsetting me how powerful this is, because I used to deal with so much other shit. You know, you're fiddling with graphics cards and RAM and hard drives and screens and everything. Now I've got high quality keyboard, I've got a high quality screen, I've got so much more space, and it's done. I buy one item and it's done. There's no more, I don't have to struggle anymore. Well, I didn't buy this, I got it for free. You should pay Rust to see the power of the computer. Let me pop open Rust and give you guys an example of how it looks. I don't know how well it's going to run. Bearing in mind that the stream is only 30 frames per second, so you're not going to see the quality. However, I do have a frame counter on the top right. But I'll just move about so you guys can see my level of graphics and how it runs. So I'm running on fantastic, I suppose. Let's do fantastic. I'd flex that, bruh. Is it 3.7? Because I saw that it runs faster than that. Sometimes it runs, it's currently at 3.9. I've already seen it run at 4 point something. I think it's got a turbo something. Because sometimes it runs at 4 point something. I think 4.4 I saw it as once. Regardless, it's very fucking strong. Just click on something with the lowest possible ping. Community. Rust, South Africa, true vanilla. Okay, bearing in mind I am doing a bunch of things now. Heading out, Mr. Flack. Have a lovely afternoon. You too. Thank you, Tor. Rapskillian, how's it going, buddy? If you run Rust on Fantastic, it uses more RAM. Really? We'll have to see now. Yeah, it will have a turbo, but you can lock it in. Okay. 4 gigahertz, 10 o'clock. Regardless, it's pretty impressive. Hello, Sinks. How's it going, buddy? Oh, you saw my tweet. Thanks, bud. Did you already give the tip? Yes, I did. I'll give you the tip again. The code is hidden between 1 minute and 2 minutes. And it's on the lower left-hand side of the screen. That's basically the crux of the tip. I don't want to repeat myself like 20 times, because I don't want to bore the people that's been here since the beginning. I'm just gonna ruin them. Hello, Kolf. How are you, my friend? John Pierre Kotzer. How's it? Von Nuzi. I've got one daughter. Her name's Kyra, and she's a fucking nightmare. I love her. Okay, cool. Because I joined late. No worry. So you guys got the codes, eh? You can press F8. What? What does that do? It doesn't do anything. Oh, when I'm in game. Okay. Oh, call figured. Lovely. Yeah, it's got 7 frames worth of footage. You're actually right. It's got 7 frames, not 3 to 5. I want to give the first clue a little bit more time, but the next one's going to be tough. It might be an audio cue. I know a lot of people earlier said they're not going to have an audio cue of any kind. I think I might have a small little audio cue. I'm thinking about it. And of course, anybody, O frames, GP frames, etc. for F8. Ah, lovely. Thank you. I didn't even know that. Good work. I've noticed though, funny enough, when I'm streaming, for some reason it takes a little bit longer to load, but when I'm off stream, it just fucking motors in there, dude. Okay, no audio cue. Okay, it's been decided. Okay, I'm running on. Let's have a look at the graphics quickly. Options. I think I turned everything to highest, naturally. Graphics. Okay, that looks pretty as high as it can go, right? We are... Depth of field. Okay, depth of field is trash. Motion blur trash. Sharpen trash. The rest is on. This is max, yes. Okay, occlusion culling I always leave off, but the other fancy stuff I did put on, and I've got 80 frames per second, and I usually get less frames at night time. You guys can see my FPS on the top right. F8. Ah, there we go. 70 frames per second. I don't know exactly what that means, but I'm gonna fucking take it. But I'm on absolute highest. You don't get Rust prettier and better than this. And as you can see, pretty dank and pretty smooth, quite frankly. It does get a lot better, I must admit, in the daytime. For some reason, this game and nighttime, you get lower frames at nighttime. You'd think you'd get more frames. Are you making a giveaway? Yes, I am, Gabriel. Have a look at my latest video. At the end of my latest video, there is a $500 pay prize giveaway. Is this a laptop? Yes, it's a laptop. It's a laptop that is 18 or 17.9 millimeters thick. And it is 2 kilograms. It's light and it's thin and it's beautiful. It's the weirdest shit, dude. So yeah, this is its power runs way too good, actually upsettingly good. Oh, it's a crazy laptop. Ah, Brendan Harrington, how are you, Brendan? I used to work with Brendan Harrington, good friend of mine. I hope it's the same Brendan Harrington. If it's not, that'll be awkward. Are you playing on it right now? Yeah, I am. Let me give you a quick look. I'm gonna pop over the bigger camera. Sorry about this. And that's it. This is the laptop. It's pretty fucking weird if you ask me. So yeah, I've pretty much decided on what brand I'm gonna be using from now on, naturally. After using a machine like this, I can't see myself using another machine ever again. Player Fruit Juice, I loved your cinematic video. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. So, you know, you guys know Rust is an indie game. Indie games are naturally more difficult to run for a computer. So I'm just going to try and generate as much struggles as possible. My turbo mode is currently activated. So we know that it's struggling. It's obviously using as much as it can. And I'm going to quickly switch over to my Predator and see what the temperatures are. Unfortunately, yes, it's the Predator Triton 500. Description in the video below, or in the link below. So I'm trying to get the CPU to be as busy as possible. Go to Bandit Camp. Let's see, where is Bandit Camp? Sorry, you guys won't be able to see my map. I've hidden my map away. I'll go to a monument. Let's just call it that. And because I want to quickly flip over to my Predator. One touch Predator button. That's the temperatures. I mean, I'm running this thing at graphically everything that I can put out. Well, I can actually put out 1,860. Jaceling, I got the same mic. Nice. It's a good mic, eh? It sounds amazing. And when I really put it through its paces, and it just fucking goes, bro. This is the harbor by the looks of it. It's very impressive. It's very impressive. Like I was saying before, I've now decided on what like. This is a short campaign for me. I'm not going to be representing Predator for a long time, but it's done. I'm representing them. I'm using their products. I will never use another product again because I've now seen what it's capable of. I mean, this tiny, thin laptop, it's solid metal. It's so fucking well put together. I can't go back to a normal PC at this stage. I'm sorry. It's like those people that go to Apple, and they love Apple to the ends of earth, and they never stop. I'm going to be like that now for this product, but that's just because I've seen its quality and everything is just so. Sorry, I probably sound like a fanboy, don't I? This mic, it's a Samsung mic. I got it from Takealot, and it's like $100, and it sounds amazing. Oh, I think I turned some volume up. Sorry, I hope you guys are having a not too boring stream. I'm just getting a sense for everything. But yeah, as you can see, the way that I navigate through the windows, like, I've got a lot of things open. You know, I've got my Discord open, I've got my Predator Sense open, I've got my Streamlabs open, Task Manager, all those CPUs. Okay, I can see 3.9 again. This thing is working its ass off, but look at it, hey? It's just a fucking warrior. Mr. Flock, how's it, buddy? How about the new Rust, your favorite hidden base, how to find the cave? Yeah, what about it, bro? The desktop could easily beat that, it would just cost more. No, absolutely, I'm not saying it's the best machine in the world. I'm saying it's the best machine for myself. Remember, I'm a YouTuber, I travel, I do things, I go out. I can't be by a desk at all times. I want a desktop machine that's not as powerful as this. And desktops will always outperform a laptop. But, you know, you can't just, you know, flip down your screen quickly and take your desktop with you. Also, another thing, what's the max resolution? Actually, don't know. Let's have a look quickly. Oh, Jesus Christ. My torch died. Whew. Okay. I'm just going to check on you quick. I think it's 1080, quite frankly. I can't imagine there'd be more. No, it's 1080. So that's the max. It's not 4K. However, I know that you can connect to 4K and have it work like that. You watch. You shat my pants, bros. Ooh, I know, dude. yeah, so... I mean, with graphics on highest, I'm getting 74 whilst running a stream and multiple programs in the background. So desktops could be more powerful, yes, but it's not that simple. And I don't know if any of the new guys saw this, but have a look at the, you know, the casing's metal, but it's got this really sexy, like, branding on it. It's so good. And this is my setup now. I've got, like, a laptop, a mouse, and a mic, and then a second screen on the left. It's like, what? Yeah, dude, it's pretty tight. I'm not gonna lie, pretty fucking tight, bro. Pretty tight. Let me just get my thing. See, I'm such a Predator fanboy now. I've put my lights on Predator blue. It used to be like a multicolor, but now I just keep it on that Predator blue, baby. Represent. I think that's right. Yeah, that's right. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this. I wanted to give you guys I know there's only like three people on this server, dude. I want to give you guys just a rundown of my new machine, as well as the new channel. Are you using 264 or NVEC to encode? NVEC. I'm actually using the graphics card. The thing is, it's a monster graphics card. It would be stupid for me. However, ooh, that's actually a good point. I'm glad you mentioned that. So, you know, laptops have, you know, its graphics card if you have a gaming laptop. Or it's got like a banana gaming. I love how you just switch. I couldn't do it. Yeah, just the alt-tabbing alone just shows you that power of that hard drive configuration. Flack, I'm bringing you food. Oh, thank you, buddy. Appreciate that. Don't bring me food. I hate it when people stream snipe me. So that is another thing. The graphics card in this machine, it's got a hybrid graphics card. It runs hybrid functionality. So it's got the Intel built-in graphics card, and it's got the 2080 RTX. The nice thing is that when you stop using your graphics, it actually, it's the weirdest thing. You stop using your graphics, and then it switches over to the, whilst you're running, it changes the driver, and it changes over to your Intel graphics card when you're not straining it. So it rests your NVIDIA graphics card and it hybridly flips over to another graphics card. It's like, what? How is that possible? Oh, and then another thing. Check out this shit, dudes. So you guys know how, you know, internet works. You can either have your LAN or your Wi-Fi connection. Can I show you guys something that's pretty strange? Whoops. Stop hitting things, bud. I hate the way that Rust exits. It never exits normal. Yes, the laptop is running RAID 0. Oh yeah, no, I have that, that's the thing, guys. RAID 0 isn't just this magical unicorn technology that allows you to only be... Oh, let me move that camera a bit more. Sorry about that, guys. It has its negatives. If one hard drive fails in RAID 0, so does the other one. Because of that dual copying thing. If you lose half of it, everything... So it's the fastest technology available, but it's not the safest. But I trust these people with my life now. I'm fairly confident that it'll be fine. So another thing, actually, this is amazing. You guys know, like, you get LAN connections and then you get Wi-Fi connections. You guys know that, right? Do you guys know the difference between a LAN connection and a Wi-Fi connection? Good enough for games. Absolutely. Not for data storage or safekeeping, but definitely gaming. So LAN works via cable and Wi-Fi is obviously wireless. Now this laptop doesn't have regular stuff. It's got killer Wi-Fi. And not just killer Wi-Fi. When I say killer, I don't mean, yeah, killer, bro. It's got a brand named Killer. And they've got a technology called DoubleShot. So when I look at my connections, what's strange about this? Oh, that's my chat's in the way. Let me just turn off my chat quickly. Sorry, I have to share you so you guys can understand. Chat, 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 chat. Let me turn off chat quickly, guys. One sec. Okay, chat's off. What looks strange about my network connection here? I'm connected to this thing called Stichling Fiber. Do you guys notice anything strange about this window? Let's see if anyone notices. You're probably not going to notice it because it's something that's. There we go, Zach D. It is currently connected to Wi-Fi and LAN at the same time. Have you ever heard of that? It can't. That's not how networks work. Except this one does. This one has the ability to connect to two internets at the same time, two separate internets. So I can connect to my neighbor's Wi-Fi and I can connect to my internet and it will literally double your bandwidth. I'm not fucking around. Killer, killer double shot Wi-Fi. So I know it's the weirdest fucking thing, bro. The best part about it is, right, the Ethernet card is a gigabit, so it runs at 1,000 meg. So is the Wi-Fi connection. I can actually transfer using Wi-Fi and cable 2 gigs down the same connection. It's the craziest thing. It's got double bandwidth. And here's the clincher. That's not the cool part. With the Predator software, right, you got this the killer software. You guys are gonna love this shit. You're gonna lose your mind. You can optimize your connection. So you can say that your Windows updates, your OBS software, and your Steam must only run over Wi-Fi and give it second priority. And then the LAN port must be dedicated to just my games connection. So it actually decides on which port gets which priority. So you can say, make sure my gaming runs on a solid LAN cable and the rest of the shit needs to run over Wi-Fi. And then it gives priority data to just your cable. It's like, dude, when I saw this shit, I was fucking mind blown. I couldn't believe it. Like, literally two connections at the same time. I know, it's insane. And I couldn't believe it. When I first saw it, I was like, no, it's not possible. It's actually not possible. Then I did some research on this killer control center on the killer brand of network devices. And it's double network. Like, exactly. Is this 2034? 2043? And I gave it a test out and I put my just rust on my cable and then I put the rest of my shit on Wi-Fi. And dude, the difference, it was just like chalk and cheese. It blew my mind. Like, I don't want to like fanboy here, but what the fuck? Wait, what is this? I've got very slow fiber, very, very slow fiber. But I mean, it's there. It's there. But like, I was so impressed with just the audio, that fancy face tracking audio and the double network abilities. Say you have a data string of, yes. Sorry, guys, if you want to understand how RAID 0 works, there you go. Look at Normal Max. He's giving you an idea of how it works. But yeah, it blows my mind with the network capabilities and the audio capabilities and then this graphics card and it. Like, I'm sold. I'm getting the next one. I don't care. Flack, can you use other PC to host a Rust server now? Well, I was actually thinking about giving it away. I mean, it's a very strong PC. I don't have a need for it, and I know there's a lot of dudes that don't have gaming PCs, so I might as well just try and spread the love. And buy his body on the server. Don't joke. Kill me, bro. Tell everybody killed Mr. Flack. But yeah, so this is my baby. This is my new monster. I'm pretty blown away by it. It's very impressive. It's got a lot of things that I didn't expect, and yeah. Anyway, I think I'm done with the announcement, guys. Can't you use it to run your stream? I could, but like, this thing handles everything anyway. Like, this thing like doesn't even struggle. What's the specs of your old PC? So I've got an i7 4790K, one of the best CPUs ever made in the world, quad core, which runs at 8 cores actually. It has 32 gigs of HyperX RAM. It's got a 970 GTX in it. 1 terabyte SSD and a couple of other things, like nothing great, decent power supply, NZXT case. Well, that sounded strange. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy it. This is going to be the I feel kind of sad. It's the final stream on my YouTube channel. Never again will I go live on my YouTube channel. Feels odd. But anyway, I'm going to be going in the next 2 minutes. Has anybody got any final questions before I go, if you don't mind? Like any concerns, anything I may have missed? If I missed anybody in the chat, please let me know now. Now would be a great time. Let me pop open that music room. I can't watch your stream on Twitch. I'm sorry. I'll try and dual stream to my new channel though. I don't want to put my Mr. Flack channel under any form of compromise anymore. So there will be no, on my main channel will just be gaming. In the description of this live stream, you'll see that there is a Gene Fanardo. There is a new channel called Extra Flack. That's me. I could stream to there potentially, but definitely not on this stream anymore. God, I love this laptop so much, dudes. Sorry, I don't want to be a bitch, but I like really love this fucking laptop. What did I miss? You missed everything. We're done. Disappointment. It is a little bit loud.
You ready to die for Mr. Flack, soldier?
I'm a streamer myself. Oh, well done. Let me give you a follow. What is your name? Electric. Is that your Steam name? Or is it your Twitch name? Sorry. Okay, let's have a look quickly. How's wifey? Oh, thank you, Evil. She's doing well. She's actually reading a book inside. I'm having a good time. Will you still have YouTube videos? Yes. The Mr. Flack video, the Mr. Flack channel is going to be dedicated to just gaming videos from now on. No more other stuff. No more just gaming related videos on Mr. Flack. Anything else on Mr. Flack Extra, and then Twitch for all my live streaming. Are you going to give the next code? The next code is going to be, yeah, no, don't worry. My channel's definitely continuing. Definitely not ending my. I just want to focus on dedicated gaming for my channel. You know, I feel like I compromise my channel whenever I upload something that's not gaming. So nice, man. Solid bit of kit. Thank you, bro. I'm so blown away by this shit.
Mr. Flack, soldier.
Flitzy Crown has followed me on Twitch and Simo and Mignoob Gamer. Good lord, that is a cool fucking name. How will you give the old PC away? I'll probably give it away on like some kind of a like.
You ready to die for Mr. Flack, soldier?
Flixie Crown has followed. Thank you so much, my friend, for the follow. I'd give it away, but if anybody does want to claim when the winner gets found, they're gonna have to pay for shipping, because unfortunately, shipping from out of South Africa is a fucking nightmare. I won't be able to ship it at my own expense, because it'll cost me more to send it to you than it will for you to pay to get it collected. I know the thing is South African customs are very broken. When you send things to and from South Africa, unless you're using a private like FedEx courier. Oh, is that you? Flixie Crown is me. Okay, Electrics, I'll give you a follow. Nice tip for you guys there. If anybody is thinking about becoming a content creator, or a Twitcher, or a streamer, or a YouTuber, what you want
to
do?
Ready to die for Mr. Flack, soldier?
What would you do for a Klondike bar? What I can suggest though, oh, you subscribed on fucking Twitch. Thank you, Simo. Who's Simo in the chat here? Who's Simo? And Crisix. What? That is so much love. Thank you, guys. Me, I'll do gaming. If you guys are doing any form of gaming content creation, one thing I can suggest to you guys is make one brand. You have editing skills. GG. Make one brand. Call yourself Mr. Flack on your Twitch, on your YouTube, on your Discord, everywhere. Because I've got like followers that try and get into gaming, and then they've got one name here, one name here, one name here, and nobody knows who they are. All of your social media, all of your emails, all of your everything that you do, your entire footprint on the internet, one name. So that everybody knows you. If you start changing the names left, right, and center, nobody's gonna get to know you. I've been on Twitch for 1 year. I'm in George on the first for my arm again, so I can drive out. Good lord, George is far. George is like 6 hours from Cape Town. Evil. I hope you know that. There are the RAID configurations, but for those you need hardware controller, usually there are. And there's a lot of beneficial RAID protocols. It's not just RAID 1. You get RAID 1. There's a lot of numbers of protocols, not just RAID 0, but absolutely. I'll start a YouTube channel under the name French Bedtime Baguette. You see, that's the thing. You've got to stick to one name. Everybody knows you as Colossib. Stick to Colossib. Sort yourself, like group yourself. Flack, will you stream Rust tonight? Would you like me to stream Rust? I can do a little bit of Rust stream tonight. I did it last night. It was quite fun. We can grab a beer and a bunny chow. It sounds good, Evil. I love it. I'll take the bunny chow. I don't actually drink liquor. I'll have like a coffee and a bunny chow. Okay, are we good, guys? Are you guys sorted? Any final questions before I say goodbye to you guys? Love you guys. Love you guys. Love you guys. Let's see. I just love Flack. I just love you. I love all of you guys so fucking much. And guys, do you see my latest video? I got to like 40,000 views in one day, dude. My mind was blown. Oh my god, I was so impressed. Flack, I can talk to you about audio. You can, I suppose. Just give me a Discord phone call, rather, not live over my stream, if you don't mind. What's your Steam name? My Steam name is Mr. Flack. There we go. You see my lesson, Mr. Flack. Steam. Mr. Flack YouTube, Mr. Flack Twitch, Mr. Flack Teespring and Twitter and all the other bollocks. Where are you going to stream last? On my Twitch. Twitch.tv/MrFlack86. Simo, thank you again for that that subscription. That was fucking sexy. I love you. Hello, Xander. How's it going? I love you too, puppy. I love all of you guys. Thank you again for all the support. I hope you guys enjoyed. Oh, that's the year I was born in, bro. I'm an old motherfucker. 1986, bro. That was a great year. It was like World War One happened then. Ah, boy, caught me, you lad. I just want to... If it's Father's Day today, so I was with my daddy. You can call me daddy if you want to, Becca. I'm not sure. Is that a boomer? Is 1986 a boomer? Guys, I had a great time, though. If you guys do want to see me, I think I'll do a bit of Rust streaming later. It's currently 6 o'clock. I'm gonna spend a little bit more time with my kid because it is Father's Day, and she was like, I want to spend time with you, and I was like, fuck it, no. And then basically I was like, okay, I'm gonna stream. I would like to just show everybody my shit. So I really enjoyed. I'm older than Flack. Good lord, you poor thing. Us oldies gotta stick together, bro. I'll only call you daddy if we roleplay. Okay, so roleplay tonight. Where are you gonna
die for Mr. Flack, soldier.
Beaver Master, 420, 69. Thanks, bud. 1983. Ah, you're 34. Nice. Happy Father's Day. Thank you, Von Uzi. I appreciate it. I'm very proud. It's Father's. I love Father's Day so much. You wake up and it's like awesome breakfast and shit. I love it so much. I mean, nice. Cool, guys. Thank you again for all the love and the happy Father's Days and the everything. I love you guys. And I hope you enjoyed the stream. You saw my awesome epic hardware. I think it's fucking... I love it. I love it so much. The year the Challenger space shuttle exploded on takeoff. Damn, what a year for NASA. Who do you think caused it? Fucking energy from me when I came out of my mom. And it like ripped the space shuttle out the sky. Not my fault. Love you. That's awesome. Okay, cool. 6 o'clock right now. I'll see you guys on Twitch in 3 hours from now. At 9 o'clock sharp in my country. 3 hours from now. Starting from... Nah. I love you guys. Can someone just explain to Aaron in the... Fuck, I'll explain it. Aaron, I'm separating my channels and I'm going live streaming on Twitch and I'm doing gaming on Mr. Flack, and then down below in the description is my new channel for everything non-Flack. Love you guys. Cheerio. Have a good one.